if you have to realize what is the responsibility of a corporate, rather than just running a plant and maybe making money. But I think more important is, how do we cultivate and create opportunities for young children to give vent to their creativity and imagination and show it to the world. Today's students are the future generations for tomorrow. And how do we create this kind of an environment so that they become more better individuals, more knowledgeable individuals, contributing to the society at larger scale and contributing to the progress of the country, I would imagine. And this is what the country needs today. Young talent from the small parts of the city or small parts of the country, come together, show your talent, and corporates like Tata's will give you enough opportunities to exhibit your talent and make sure that you have a successful career as we go along. If I have to look from the company perspective, I am very proud to be part of the company which believes in this, which demonstrates this. But I think it's that ethos of Tata culture which Sanjay was mentioning. This firmly is ingrained in our DNAs, that how do we take care of the children of the society and make them flourish, make them better individuals. Sheer enormity of this exhibition makes me feel very proud that I belong to this company, and the students who are here, we can contribute in some little manner on your growth and on your aspirations.
Thank you. Thank you. Dear shareholders, good afternoon. Welcome to the 38th Annual General Meeting of Tata Steel Long Products Limited. This meeting is being conducted over audiovisual means. My name is Shankar Bhattacharya and I am the Company Secretary and Compliance Officer of the company. I would like to take you through certain details relating to your participation at this meeting. The facility of joining the AGM through audiovisual means is being made available for members on first-come, first-served basis. All members who have joined this meeting are by default placed on mute mode by the host to avoid any disturbance arising from background noise and to ensure smooth and seamless conduct of the meeting. Once we commence the Q&A session, the chairman will sequentially announce the name of the shareholders who have conveyed their desire to speak at this meeting. Upon being called, the host will give appropriate access to the concerned shareholder to speak. Before you commence speaking, please be mindful of the following. Use the earphones so that the narrative is clearly audible to all participants. Remember to minimize noise in the background. Ensure that you have a strong Wi-Fi connection and the same is not connected to other devices. Ensure that no other background applications are running on the device that you are connected from. And remember to switch on the video and ensure that you have adequate background lighting at your place. If you are unable to join through video for any reason, request you to speak through the audio means. If the speaker shareholder has a connectivity problem, we'll call on the next speaker to join. Once the connectivity improves, the speaker shareholder may again be called on to speak after all other registered shareholders have spoken. We request the speaker shareholders to please limit their speech to 3 minutes. During the course of the AGM, shareholders facing technical issues may kindly contact the helpline number provided in the notice of AGM. As you are aware, the Companies Act 2013 and SEBI listing regulations provide for electronic voting. Accordingly, the company provided to its members the facility to cast their vote through the remote electronic voting system administered by NSDL. The facility for voting at the meeting is being made available for those members who have not cast their votes through the remote electronic voting system and are participating in this meeting. This remote electronic voting system will be made available during this meeting once announced by the chairman. Members who have not yet cast their vote and wish to do so may please visit NSDL's e-voting website and cast their vote while continuing to watch the proceedings of the meeting. Mr. Novin Kothari, practicing company secretary, has been appointed as the scrutinizer to scrutinize the votes cast at the meeting and through remote e-voting process. Since the AGM is being held through audiovisual means and the resolutions forming part of the notice convening this meeting have been already put to vote through the remote e-voting process, the practice of proposing and seconding of resolutions is not required and will not be followed. Thank you for your attention. Over to Chairman.
Thank you, Shankar. Good afternoon, shareholders. I hope you and your families are safe and in good health. I welcome you all to the 38th Annual General Meeting of the company. As the requisite quorum is present, I call the meeting to order. I will now call on the directors who are on video conference to introduce themselves. I request Dr. Saugato Ray to introduce himself.
Thank you, Chairman. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Saugato Ray, and I am an independent director of the company. I am attending the AGM through video conferencing from my residence in Kolkata. I am the chairman of the Stakeholders Relationship Committee and also a member of the Risk Management Committee and Nomination and Remuneration Committee. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Srikumar Menon.
Kumar Menon. My name is Srikumar Menon and I am an independent director of the company. I am attending the AGM through video conferencing for my residence in Kolkata. I am the chairman of the Audit Committee and the Corporate Social Responsibility Committee, CSR, of the company.
Thank you. Dr. Anshuman Das. Dr. Das,
I am in the AGM through video.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry. Can I go ahead now?
Yes, please.
Sure. Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Suman Das and I'm an independent director of the company. I'm attending the AGM through video conferencing from my residence at Bhubaneswar. I'm the chairman of the Safety, Health and Environment Committee and a member of the Stakeholders Relationship Committee and Corporate Social Responsibility Committee of the company. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Das. Mr. Shashikant Modgal.
Thank you, Chairman. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shashikant Modgal, and I am an independent director of the company. I am attending the AGM through video conferencing from my residence in Mumbai. I am the chairman of the Nomination and Remuneration Committee and the Risk Management Committee, and a member of the Audit Committee and of the Safety, Health, and Environment Committee of the company. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Neeta Karmakar.
Thank you, Chairman. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Neeta Karmakar, and I'm an independent director of the company. I'm attending the AGM through video conferencing from a residence in Kolkata. I'm a member of the Audit Committee of the company. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kaushik Chatterjee.
Thank you, Chairman, and good afternoon, shareholders. My name is Kaushik Chatterjee, and I'm a non-executive director of the company. I'm attending the AGM through video conferencing from my residence in Mumbai. I'm a member of the Audit Committee and the Nominations and Remuneration Committee of the company. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Dr. Debashish Bhattacharjee.
Thank you, Chairman. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Debashish Bhattacharjee, and I'm a non-executive director of the company. I'm attending the AGM through video conferencing from my residence in Kolkata. I'm a member of the Risk Management Committee and the Safety, Health, and Environment Committee of the company. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Meena Lal.
Thank you, Chairman. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Meena Lal, and I am a non-executive director of the company. I am attending the AGM through video conferencing from my residence in Bangalore. I am a member of the Risk Management Committee of the company. Thank you.
Thank you. I now call on the managing director of the company, who is also on video conference, to introduce himself.
Thank you, Chairman. My name is Ashish Anupam, and I am the managing director of Tata Steel Long Products. I'm attending the AGM through my office in Jamshedpur. Thank you.
Thank you. I now call on the Joint Chief Financial Officer of the company to introduce himself.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sanjay Kumar Srivastava, and I am the Joint Chief Financial Officer of the company. I am attending the AGM through video conferencing from my office in Kolkata. Thank you.
Thank you. I would now like to welcome the company's union representatives to the AGM. We value their contribution in maintaining industrial harmony at the company's establishments and thank them for their support during the ongoing pandemic. Today we have with us Mr. B.K. Dinda, who is the president of the Tata Kamgar Union Gamharia, Mr. Raj Kumar, working president of Tata Kamgar Union Gamharia, Mr. Ajay Das, general secretary Tata Kamgar Union Gamharia, Mr. Sanjay Kumar Mahanta, President, Tata Steel Long Products Workers Union, Joda. Mr. Ramesh Chandra Behra, General Secretary, Tata Steel Long Products Workers Union, Joda. Mr. Pinaki Chaudhary, Representative of Pricewaterhouse & Co., Chartered Accountants, LLP, Statutory Auditors of the Company. Mr. S.M. Gupta, Representative of Messrs. S.M. Gupta & Co., Secretarial Auditors of the Company. Mr. Kunal Banerjee, Representative of Messrs. Shom & Banerjee, Cost Auditors of the Company. And Mr. Naveen Kotari, representative of Messrs. NK and Associates Practicing Company Secretaries, a scrutinizer for the electronic voting, are also attending the meeting. Due to COVID-19 concerns, lockdown and social distancing norms, we are holding this annual general meeting through audiovisual means. This format is in compliance with the directions of the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Government of India, as well as the Securities and Exchanges Board of India. A live streaming of this meeting is also being made available through the website of NSDA. The company has taken the requisite steps to enable shareholders to participate and vote on the items being considered at this AGM. The company has received one letter along with board resolution from corporate shareholder appointing and authorizing representatives under Section 113 of the Companies Act 2013 in respect to 3,37,86,521 equity shares representing 74.91% of the total voting capital. Since the physical attendance of shareholders is dispensed with, the requirement of appointing proxies is not applicable. The registers are required under the Companies Act 2013 are open for inspection in electronic mode. Should you wish to inspect, please write to the company secretary at the email address mentioned in the notice convening this meeting. Shareholders who have not cast their vote earlier through the remote e-voting can do so during the course of the meeting through remote e-voting facility. Before we proceed, I would like to share my thoughts on the business environment and the performance of your company. The past 18 months have been challenging for all of us in our own ways. We have seen unprecedented times due to the spread of the COVID-19 pandemic across the world, and it has not yet abated, with multiple variants of the virus still a threat to human life. In these times, it is important for us to continue to maintain COVID-appropriate behavior. As part of the efforts to combat COVID-19, your company had supported approximately 22,300 people in three locations, namely Joda, Normandy, and Gamaria, besides help extended through government agencies. Your company remains committed to supporting the community in the best possible manner. Turning to the broader economy, the first wave of the pandemic brought economic activity to a near standstill in almost all major economies during the first half of the financial year 2021, and global growth has declined by 3.5% in 2020. In India too, the GDP declined by about 7.7% year on year. During these challenging times, your company displayed agility in several aspects to remain resilient in all key areas, namely people, operations, market, and financials. On the people front, intense leadership communication at all levels, coupled with the deployment of the pod concept and sanitization measures, helped us to keep our workplace safe without any operational disruption. The pandemic forced all of us in a new work paradigm of remote working, something that we could not have experienced otherwise. On the customers front, your company quickly ramped up exports amid lockdowns in the domestic market during the first quarter of FY21 and secured new customers. The operations area, supply chain, geared up to handle disruption, and several new trials started to create value out of the crisis. Despite disruption caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, your company has turned around the business on multiple fronts. Your company achieved a top-line growth of 36% year-on-year, driven by the best-ever production of both steel and DRI, mix enrichment, and improved market conditions, especially in H2 FY21. Strong operational turnaround translated into robust bottom-line performance as well. Your company's EBITDA grew multifold and clocked 1,154 crores, coupled with a positive net profit of 572 crores, as against a loss of 516 crores in the financial year 2019-20. Accordingly, your board has recommended a dividend of rupees 5 per equity share of face value of rupees 10 each for financial year 2021. Your company strongly focused on cash flow management while pursuing deleveraging of its balance sheet. I'm happy to inform that your company in financial year 2021 has cleared in advance long-term loan installments falling due until March 27 and deleveraged the balance sheet by 1,325 crores. Your company is now set to grow and diversify through multiple options. Further, the company is exploring possibilities to reach the nameplate capacity of 1 million tons, coupled with investment in downstream and finishing facilities for balancing the capacity and meeting customer requirements. As we move forward, sustainability remains a core issue for the steel industry and is a key pivot for our strategy. Your company has developed a long-term strategy roadmap for 2030, after considering ESG aspects and initiated seeding actions in focused areas. Your company is continuously working to strengthen its safety practices and accelerate the pace of the technological and digital journey with required investments. Developing a culture of customer obsession, agility, and innovation are our key priorities. These would enable your company to become future ready, not just structurally and financially, but culturally as well. I thank each of you for having faith and confidence in the company and appreciate your continued support to the company and the management. Since the notice is already circulated to all the shareholders, I take the notice convening this meeting as read. Since there is no observation, qualification, adverse remarks or comment by the statutory auditors in the report on financial statements for the year ended March 31st, 2021, or matters which have any adverse effect on the functioning of the company, the auditor's report is taken as read. I now request Mr. Ashish Anupam, Managing Director, to make a presentation on the operational and the financial performance of the company.
Thank you, Chairman. Once again, welcoming all the shareholders to the 38th Annual General Meeting of Tata Steel Long Products. I hope you and your family members are safe and healthy. In the next 15 to 20 minutes, I would like to take you through some of the key highlights of the company's performance for the financial year FY21. Next slide, please. This will be the broad agenda item for my presentation. Next slide. Tata Steel Long Products remains committed towards safety, health, and environment. Now, if you look at the safety, while in Joda operations, the company remained LTI-free for the second consecutive year. And in our minds, post the fatality which we had in the month of May, we had remained LTI-free. Our Gamharia operations remains a bit of a challenge, where the management, along with the union leaders, are making efforts to bring about a cultural change in this area. The focus is towards strengthening the fundamentals, like training, developing new standard operating procedures, which are being made with a strong focus on process safety management as well. On the environment front, the company is progressing well on all the fronts, with action plans being made towards continuously bringing down the carbon footprint. Post the pandemic, the special emphasis has been in the area of health, with creating new apps for health and wellness, and of late concentrating towards vaccination of our employees. Next slide, please. Pandemic posed several challenges to India Inc. in terms of stability, but your company responded positively to the challenges and took several initiatives to combat the COVID. If you look at the community, several initiatives were taken to look at the community which we serve by providing medical help, medical kits, and other essentials items for their livelihood. We also provided special assistance to the migrant workers who did not have jobs by giving them some engagement in the company and in the nearby area as well. In the area of employees, we launched, as I said, a wellness app, which takes care of mental, physical, and social needs of the employees. We also came out with a family benefit scheme for the people whom we lost during this COVID-19. In the area of operations and plants, initiatives like POD, various scenario-based planning, focusing on logistics and supply chain, and agility towards shifting to international markets for quick sales in the export market as well. So overall, looking at the financial stability, a war room used to be held every day to focus on liquidity and tight cash management. Next slide, please. FY21 had been a difficult year for the economy, and as we all know, the GDP showed a negative slightly above 7%. The economic growth was on a downward trend due to financial sector weakness and COVID outbreak. Quarter one of FY21 saw the first degrowth in last four decades. The demand for the steel sector remained muted and sluggish in the first half of H1, but however picked up pretty robustly in second half of FY21. To almost its pre-pandemic levels. Both our steel and DRI businesses picked up growth and momentum in the second half, remained buoyant, and the prices remained buoyant due to cost push and better demand, as I mentioned, in H2 of FY21. Next slide, please. In spite of all the challenges, your company showed resilience and came out stronger on all fronts. We showed best of a production in both steel and DRI. For the first time, the PAT showed a swing of almost more than 1,000 crores. Long-term debts came down sharply. Morale and the employee engagement was at all high-time levels. And overall, we focused on customer centricity by multi-level engagement and deepening our connect with the customers. Next slide, please. Some of the key highlights which I wanted to put over here. The revenue moved up almost by 36%. Production of steel and DRI was up by 11% and 4% respectively. EBITDA went up 6 times. And during this time, we also produced 50 new products. And the company also saw the lowest rejection levels, what we call the PPM rejection from the customer in the last couple of years. We also had several synergy benefits with our parent Tata Steel, and the synergy benefits were all across the value chain, whether it's in procurement, operation, marketing and sales, and various other means. We also touched the lives more than 550,000 people during the CS with the CSR activities. Next slide, please. Your company has crafted out a turnaround plan in FY21. The focus in quarter one was to build resilience through various scenario planning, quickly moving to sales in export markets, strong focus on cash and working capital management to combat the nationwide lockdown. In quarter two, as the market started to open up, we pushed the limits to achieve high production and sales numbers and started to prepayment of our long-term loans. In quarter three, we focused on diversifying our customer and market with new customers and new approvals and debottlenecking our capacity And for the first time in quarter three, the company started to show positive PBT. And quarter four were all about enriching a product mix. And in this quarter, we had a landmark EBITDA of crossing 500 crores and almost 950 crores of deleveraging was done in this quarter. All in all, every quarter and quarter, we saw improvement in revenue, improvement in production, which resulted in definitely in better financials as the quarter moved on in the FY21. Next slide, please. To align the business with long-term goals, your company has redefined its vision and mission and built strategic directions and objectives, which are listed here, basically to become the most preferred supplier in the chosen marketing segments, achieve sustainable, profitable goal. At the same point of time, be a respected corporate citizen and become an employer of choice. And this will be our guiding philosophy as the company moves forward in the next decade. Next slide, please. In order to become the preferred supplier, the company is continuously enhancing its presence and focusing on mixed enrichment. It has maintained its leadership position in the commercial vehicle segment and shown significant growth in the component export as well. It is continuously working on diversifying its product portfolio by getting various approvals from the new passenger vehicle and the two-wheeler segment in the auto segment. It is also making efforts to enter into the non-auto segments in a small manner in agriculture, railways, and the bearing industry as well. Next slide, please. In order to enhance customer centricity, key interventions have been made in the company in the last financial year. A new online customer voice portal has been created. Creating various listening posts with multi-level and deepening engagement with customers has been started. Focusing on value creation with customers, which through our customer service team, which are dedicated with few of the auto OEMs, which we have just started. Company is also pioneered in developing some of the first of its product in the country, like the tire cord wire rod, the wire rod for cable wires, and also preparing lead-free steel for the benefit and the safe environment for our employees. Next slide, please. To realize our strategy, achieving profitable growth, operational robustness is one of the critical factors. And consistent improvements quarter and quarter has been witnessed in the last financial year in most of the operational parameters which we saw in FY21. Next slide. To ensure operational robustness, company has also taken various initiatives throughout the year. It has achieved approximately 500 crores of savings through transformation program called Shikhar, and used this crisis of COVID as an opportunity in making 70 plus almost new trials during the year, which will be defining the new paradigm shift in the coming years as well. Company has also realized the importance of going digital and has taken various steps in this direction as well. For example, DigiTwin is the beginning of the Industry 4.0 at Tata Steel Long Products, enabling remote manufacturing at our Jodha plant. It has also a virtual command and control center with machine learning. And going forward, we will embed artificial intelligence to optimize cost, efficiency, and quality of our products. In addition, various new business processes are being digitized along with launch of a TPM to move with agility, with data-driven insights, and quick and more importantly, informed decision-making as we move forward in our journey. Next slide, please. Overall, the company has shown a good financial results. As mentioned earlier, the company has registered 36% year-on-year growth in revenue, 6 times year-on-year growth in the EBITDA, and company for the first time has achieved a PBT of 600 crores plus. In addition, it also shown success. It has been successful in bringing down the working capital to just over 50 days. And overall, the market cap has also moved close to 3,000 crores at the end of the last financial year. Next slide, please. As we all know, sustainability is gaining significant importance as we move forward. Your company has taken a holistic view to attain leadership in this area as we move forward. In order to achieve sustainable business practices across the value chain, companies rolled out responsible supply chain policy in addition to the sustainable policy in FY21. We have identified 7 key areas for long-term perspective and improvements have started to show in FY21 itself. And companies started to work both at long-term and short-term strategy to achieve benchmark levels in all the seven areas in sustainability. Next slide, please. Companies continuously focusing on improving the quality of life for the proximate communities. And in this regard, we have spent last year 88 lakhs on the CSR activities, in addition to mobilizing various resources in the form of subsidies from the government. The focus on CSR activities has been directed in six strategic directions: education, health and sanitation, livelihood enhancement, skill building, youth engagement, and essential services for the well-being of the society. Voluntarism is also being encouraged, and a good participation is being seen all across the value chain and all the centers of Tata Steel Long Products. Next slide. In order to keep the morale high and make the company happy and a rewarding place, your company in FY21 has rolled out various initiatives and policies. Different kinds of policies have been rolled out creating various communication platforms across the centers, across the levels. Reward and recognition schemes have been rolled out. Capability building programs and team building platforms have been created, which has encouraged employees, and the employee engagement has been at a very high levels of 80% in Tata Steel Long Products. Next slide. In this journey of becoming a partner of choice with all your stakeholders, slowly the efforts have started to get recognized at all levels. The company got the first prize award at the national level for conservation of energy. And in the area of innovation, we had the first patented a product. And we have got various awards on community service and volunteerism. And more importantly, we have started to receive awards and letters of appreciation from our dear customers on our service and products during this year of FY21. Thank you, and wishing all a safe and a healthy year ahead. Thank you very much. Back to you, Chairman, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Ashish. I will now call upon the shareholders who registered to speak. So I will start with Mr. Arun Bopanna. Mr. Arun Kumar Bopanna.
Mr. Bopanna, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Hello. Yeah. Okay. Hello.
Yeah, Dr. Arun, please go ahead.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Good afternoon. Thanks to Shankar Bhattacharya for arranging this seamless VC and for the presentation to the MD Ashish Anupam. In this once in a century crisis, COVID, loss of lives, livelihoods, and unemployment, Tata Steel gave 800 tons of oxygen per day for healthcare in need and remained silent as always. Tata's and history are referred as parallel government in crisis. I am proud of Tata's. My question, sir, what is the vaccination drive at Tata Steel Long Products? Is everybody vaccinated there? Repurposing assets to extend the economic and the earning capacity. Are we writing off any legacy assets because this is an old company? How are we getting future ready? What are the strategies, targets for 2030? As sustainability is vital. With 65 crore young Indians, major urban development, this looks optimistic for steel. We may not see a drastic change immediately, but surely we can create hope for change. Tata Steel Long Products views and comments. India has survived as a democracy and even built a good industrial base. Still, it is not India of our dreams. Why and what can TSLP do? Will JN Tata Spirit Junoon motivate young Indians for national integration with pride, strengthen social fabric, security and stability? In the rapid rise of ESG, TSLP actions. Lastly, JN Tata, a nationalist, a patriotic, changed the course of Indian industry. JRD Tata treated workers with uncommon dignity and respect. Ratan Tata sunsetted and sold underperforming businesses, expanded Tata's purview through partnerships, and now the current chairman, Chandras, is looking for simplifying, synergizing, scaling up, and I'm proud of the Tata chairman. So it is said, beware of your grandchildren. It was a message to all the tycoons. Four generations and more, 150 years over, after its founding, Tata is not only still standing, but essential, all of which is say, Tatas are remarkable. In conclusion, Jamshedpur was and is a cradle for steel education. It produced Tata Sons chairmen and chief ministers, etc. Magnificent people are carefully created by God. Magnificent moments are carefully planned by God. Magnificent friends like Tatas are carefully gifted by God. Thank you very much, Tatas. I wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Arun. Mr. Saket Kapoor.
Mr. Kapoor, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Audible now?
Yes,
good afternoon. Good afternoon. Namaskar, sir. Thank you for this opportunity. Sir, firstly, our being a long product company, would like to know from the team, how is the demand shaping up with the user, from the user industries? Since the prices have moved up, has that led to any shrug off in demand, especially the automobiles, white goods, and the other sectors which we are catering to? Sir, if some light could be thrown on how the utilization levels have shaped up for quarter three and quarter four, and also for quarter one, for which the numbers are already in the public domain. And sir, being an investor, would also like to understand, sir, the sustainability of the cyclicality in the steel cycle, sir. Where are we today in this? If one could say the euphoric rise in the steel prices, if 60-70% over a very short period of time, because of the X and Y factors of China and other issues with productions and all, where are exactly we? Because investors who are committed to steel industry through their investment in the Tata Group companies, especially the steel sectors, are always being adverse to the cyclical factor. But is the situation anything different than what things have been earlier? If you could throw some light on how and what are the improvements in the fundamentals that could support these, at least support these steel prices for a far, far near term than what have been earlier, sir. Sir, there has, if you could share some update on the merger with India Steel Wires and the reasons for being challenged or returned by SEBI, and what is the way forward? And the government have very recently come up with this PLI scheme, sir. How can Tata Long Product being a beneficiary of it? Are we participating through it, and what are the benefits? So we have seen that the royalty charges have gone up significantly. So I think it is due to this MMDR Act amendment. So how are these charges different than what they were for the last 1 year? And also, sir, how are we coping up with this high raw material prices, both in terms of coking coal and iron ore? And what portion of our requirements are captive? Sir, in your presentation, Ashish sir has mentioned about the saving of around 505 crore rupees. I would like to understand further for what period that has been attributed to that 505 crore, and which are the areas where we have saved this amount of money, and is this sustainable or one time? If something more could be dwelled on it. And I'll conclude by my earlier request also, only the forum has changed. That's a we did found this investor presentation post our annual numbers, but over a period of time on a quarterly basis, although we are getting monthly updates on the production and the volume numbers, but the business update post the quarterly numbers are not a part of the curriculum for Tata Long Products, and we investors are finding it difficult to make a good understanding of how the numbers have been. So through this forum, I would request the MD, the chairman sir, to look into the prospect of the same, so that we get an equal platform to have a better understanding and continue with the journey of Tata Long Products going forward. I wish the well-being of all people, every staff associated with the company, and I hope that going forward, this pandemic will also fade away with time. And sir, this virtual medium should be made at least from the Tata Group. We can look forward as a permanent part, even though physical AGM may or may not happen. But at least put this virtual platform, because it has commanded its merit over this 18 months, and everybody will second my view on the same. Thank you for this patient hearing, sir, and looking forward to a better times ahead, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Kapoor. Mr. Abhisar Jain.
Mr. Jain, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Yeah, hi, good afternoon. Can you hear me?
Yes, please. Yes, Mr. Jain.
Yes, good afternoon, sir. My name is Abhisar Jain, and I am representing Mona KIF. We are investors into Tata Steel Long Products through our Long Only Equity Fund, MNCL Capital Compounder Fund. Sir, first of all, I would like to congratulate all the board members as well as all the employees of Tata Steel Long for a remarkable turnaround and for having, seamlessly kind of integrated the Usha Martin plant. We, of course, have seen the numbers, and the deleveraging has been phenomenal, to say the least. Secondly, I would also like to, put my congratulations to you for a very nice annual report, which was an integrated annual report where there was a lot of, long-term strategy, which was also mentioned, particularly the goals towards 2030, having the carbon footprint in under control and pursuing the EAF route, which, of course, is the need of the hour. Now, coming to, sir, the questions that we have as investors, as looking for a very long-term investment into your company. Sir, the first thing is that we have seen phenomenal deleveraging, as I said. But now, I think the need of the hour is to look for growth. And that is one area which we as investors feel that maybe we have lagged a little bit, considering, the strong cycle that we are into. So we had very little capex in FY21, but just some 50 crores or something. So I just want to know that, what will be the immediate growth capex plans, and, the finished steel capacity volumes that we have of 650 KT. What volumes can we try to do in FY22 and FY23? So from the near term perspective, can we have some growth options? Second question is, sir, on mention of the 1 million ton expansion in phase two. You have mentioned it in annual report very clearly that has been decided, but there are no details around the capex and what kind of product profile we are looking at. So it'll be great if you can give us some timeline, some capex number on that, and what kind of product profile. Third, sir, as Tata Steel, the parent, with Mr. Chairman, you head, you guys have clearly said that Tata Steel Long will look for some inorganic opportunity at this company level, Tata Steel Long. So I just want to ask you that, do we have any cutoff limit when pursuing the inorganic option in terms of the debt equity or the debt to EBITDA? That we would keep in mind and not look at above those numbers, because as you can very well appreciate, in this cycle being so strong, every asset will be hotly contested, and we fear that we should not be overpaying. And so lastly, I don't have this as a question, but just as a thought. Sir, I want to convey this thought that, look, now post-merger with Tata Metallics, we will have three locations, and I have been to your plants at all these three locations in the past, because I was a sell-side analyst earlier. So I believe that there is a lot of scope of brownfield expansion at all these three locations. The Jodha plant has huge land bank, you have Kharagpur Tata Metallics and Gamharia. Now, how would you balance, doing a brownfield expansion in these locations through a preferred mode where you can keep the carbon footprint in control, because you can choose your options there, versus, say, buying out a NINL where you get a blast furnace which is high carbon footprint, or any other plant which is blast furnace and which is high carbon footprint. So I would say that considering your goals that you have outlined in the annual report for 2030, it might be more prudent to look at our existing locations and do our preferred mode through keeping the carbon footprint low. So that's just my opinion, just my thoughts. You of course can say whatever you want to say on them. And thank you so much, sir, for this opportunity to speak here. And once again, thanking and congratulating the board members as well as all the employees for a phenomenal turnaround which we have seen. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Jain. Mr. Ram Janki Sri Gopal Maheshwari.
Mr. Maheshwari, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. My questions are very simple. You are now merging the three companies, which is India Steel, which was, as mentioned by the previous speaker, was sort of stalled by SEBI. So what is the current status on the merger between the three entities? And if you could give a timeline and also give a broad overview on what's the rationale of the merger? How does our company get benefited? Because Tata Metalics is more of a downstream company. We are an upstream company. So if you could just quantify the benefits and how you see the combined entity over a 2 to 3 year period. As a thumb rule for the DRI, which is a sponge iron, as well as the Usha Martin 1MT plant, what would be the indicative replacement cost of assets per ton or indicatively? With respect to the expansion, is there which is mentioned in the annual report, how you plan to balance the expansion and the debt profile, whether you want to repay some more debt, and what would be the sustainable debt ratios which you want to be where you are comfortable. Is there any further scope to increase profitability in both the DRI business and the Usha Martin? And how the Usha Martin's acquisition has gone through, whether any positive or negative surprises, and how do you raise capacity utilization over there? As mentioned by the earlier speaker, what could be your CapEx spends for FY22 and 23. The chairman also mentioned there is a roadmap for 2030 for the company. Could you just sort of elaborate in terms of what you intend to achieve over the next decade? And the CEO also mentioned in the PPT that there have been an entry into the EV segment. What is this? Can you please develop more on this? That's it from my side. I would thank you for the strong operational performance, but more importantly, also the work which you've done on the community front. Thank you and stay safe.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Maheshwari. We have Mr. Manoj Kumar Gupta next.
Mr. Gupta, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Hello. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Manoj ji. कैसे हैं आप?
मैं ठीक हूँ. आप कैसे हैं?
हम ठीक हैं.
I'm very happy to see you because we are meeting last 2 years in the VC, sir.
Yes.
Let's pray to God for healthy and prosperous, safe, long life to everyone. Sir. Thanks, Chairman, respected Chairman, Board of Directors, fellow shareholders. My name is Manoj Gupta. I'm equity shareholder of Tata Steel Long Products, sir. First of all, I thanks to our Chairman and his team for good result in this epidemic COVID-19 and very good dividend of 50%. Some companies has skipped the dividend due to the lockdown, but it's a Tata's that who want to believe to return this investors in any time. So it's thanks to you, your team, and especially our MD. I'm very happy to see the 17 minutes is the presentation of how he runs the company in last 2 years. So I'm very happy to see, because when I attend the Tata's meeting, I find that MD presents some thing to investors so that investors can understand what is happening in the company. And sir, what will be your next target, to acquire or merge? Because you have already announced three mergers. So in 2018, you have acquired Bhushan, 19 Usha Martin, 20 pandemic COVID has gone. In 21, you have acquired Rohit Ferro. So what will be your next target to acquire under your MDC in Tata Steel? Tata Steel will be a big company in coming 5 years. So what can you throw some highlights? So what will be your next target to acquire or and how the employees and investors will be benefited to merge all three companies in Tata Long Products? Because Tata Long will be big company in the under the umbrella of Tata Steel after merge this company. I will not say a single word on the merger when the merger meeting will be called NCLT. I will say at that time, but what will be the impact to the investors and the employees after merger of these three companies? And sir, what's your future as a MD of Tata Steel and as a chairman of these companies? What's your future outlook for next 5 years of the Tata Steel Long Products? Because you are going to merge the DI pipe, and DI pipe demand will increase because the nation is spreading. And the entire nation, because the drainage system are very old, more than 60 year old. So all drainage system will be changed by the state governments. So what will be our stand and what will be our status in that time when the states will go? And sir, Richard, I totally agree with Dr. Arun Bopanna's view that Tata is Tata. No one compare in the country with Tata's. Tata runs a parallel government with the central government. What central government thinks today, tomorrow Tata thinks today for the community, society and the nation. So I salute you that you have done a wonderful job in the second wave of COVID-19 to serve the nation by supplying the oxygen gas 800 ton every day to the nation. So it's a good gesture for this community and society, sir. And sir, have you any plan to shift the registered office to the city of Joy? Earlier you have a plan, but you have dropped that plan. So now you are going to merge one company from the city of Joy with Tata Long. So what's your plan to bring back the registered office of Tata Long to Calcutta? We people of Calcutta like you very much. So bring one registered office again in this city, sir. And we always want to see you in a smiling face, sir. Because it's a try to reduce the debts. Debts are increasing, so try to reduce the debts and how you will reward to the employees and shareholders in future, sir. Or if possible, sir, kindly arrange a plant visit, if possible. Then kindly ask the company secretary to arrange a plant visit when the situation improves and situation permits to allow the shareholders to enter. And how much cost will come for the expansion of brownfield? And how you will arrange that fund, sir? Thank you, sir. I have a great respect and regards to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Manoj Gupta. Mr. Dinesh Kotecha.
Mr. Kotecha, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Sir, can you am I audible?
Yes, please. Yes, sir.
And can I start my video also, sir? I would like to.
Sure.
Yeah. Good evening, sir. I had opportunity. First of all, my humble regards to all the directors on the board. Sir, I'm meeting you for the first time by audio visual. I had an opportunity to listen to one of your on calls last time. And I was very happy because I am a long, very long old shareholder of the company. And at the cost of not repeating anything, I would like to, just congratulate you for your resolute performance turnaround. And it's a case study now for 2021. It's a case study of a big turnaround. I found that, the Q4 and the Q1 results, when I see together, you have come up to nearly 18 crores turnover per day. So can we calculate 20 crores turnover per day for the full year? I can do my calculations, sir. And the margins, which were, in 24-25% range operating, has gone up to 33%. Very good. Now, as against last year's loss of 516 crores for the full year, you have made a strong, strong turnaround of 571 crores. Fantastic. This is in spite of, you know, all the difficulties that we are facing, and in spite of, despite of all that, and in spite of so many problems that we have got, we have been able to come up winners. And sir, I would just like to caution you, because, you know, celebrations and hangovers must stop. The first innings has been played very nice. Now let us prepare for the new mission to be acquired, and that new mission should be 10,000 crores in 3 years, sir. That is my wish. Again, you know, your annual report, integrated annual report was fantastic. I would like to have a physical copy. I request Mr. Shankar Bhattacharya ji to send me one copy. Sir, I would, you know, like to have some of my questions have already been asked by somebody. On page 67, customer service teams, 4 have been set up in 2021. And you said that we will set up 10. That means, does it mean additional 6 or additional 10? In 21-22, and in this first quarter, how many we have set up, I would like to know. And the second one is launch of ACE, Assure, Correct and Ensure. You launched in the last quarter of the last year, 21, Q4 on 25th of February. Sir, I would like to know, what is the response of that, you know? And in that response, whatever negative response has come, how are you taking care of that negative response? Where customers are finding some problems in the ACE launch. Do you receive some negative suggestions also there? Sir, on page 97, all your 8 key financial ratios, all are highly rewarding. All have turned from negative to positive. Now, all this is, sir, because of your strong realization which you have got, which is 5 times more than the last year. Now, is it a one-time thing, or will it be constant now, or will it, is there a possibility of decreasing in the realizations or increasing, and how are you going to do that? So your BRR is very good. All comprehensive information which was needed is provided. One subsidiary we have got, TSIL Energy. Now I think there's no sales there, so can you tell me the rationale of that particular thing? And another company we have got some state Camping 01 something. I mean, I would like to know what is happening to that. Disputed cases under page 157. What is the latest update and the legal expense incurred on these disputed cases, sir? Sir, other than that, several questions I had of small questions, but one more remains, that is there an employee excellence award initiated in the company? If it is there, you should mention it very clearly. I would like to know who was the best employee in the company. And sir, nasty surprises, black swans, contingency of worst types, are, we have faced this for the last 18 months in the form of COVID. How are we prepared for any such black swans or contingencies or nasty surprises coming up in future? Maybe by, let us say, by March 24, COVID in the second form and another form is going to strike again, wave 3, they are saying. So I am very much disturbed, you know, and Orissa and your West Bengal, these are politically little bit disturbed area. So is there any labor disturbances of major type there? And if it is there, how is the HR coordinating with it or coping with it? Please, and thank you very much, sir. Sir, I'm very happy to see you on the virtual meeting, and hope to see you sometime. I'm from Bombay. My name is Dinesh Koteja. My folio number is 12018970564. I am a shareholder of practically all Tata share companies. Thank you very much.
Namaskar. Thank you, Mr. Koteja. Mr. Jaydeep Bakshi.
Mr. Bakshi, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Good afternoon, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, Mr. Bakshi. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, Chairman, MD, and Board of Directors. Myself, Jaydeep Bakshi, connecting from the city of Kolkata. Thanks to our company secretary, Mr. Shankar Bhattacharya, for giving an opportunity to express my views, and also to the secretarial department, also to the support team for conducting this video conference in a smooth manner. So our integrated report is well presented, giving a review of the financial performances. We are at a high-end specialty steel manufacturing, crossing many hurdles. Congrats to the management and the entire team for giving a positive result in this difficult period. Sir, how much has been the business affected due to supply chain disruptions? And sir, have we faced any difficulty in raw material, though our iron ore mines are near the production units? Sir, highlight on our plans to achieve leadership position in specialty steel with 25% market share by 2030. Sir, what is our order book position from OEM in commercial vehicles and railways? Sir, digitization initiative to optimize resolution resource utilization is a good initiative by our company. So congrats also for the water management attended 100% water recycling and effluent treatment for reuse of inside plant. And also for the awards which we have received, and surely for the dividend of rupees 5 which you have passed on to us. And also to mention especially for the first, for the maintaining the first position for national energy conservation. So what is our target and roadmap for the development of new products in the coming years? Or can we have the target percentage for being debt-free year-wise? So also congrats to the team, maybe the R&D team for development of steel for tire rod for the Thailand company. Our trials have been approved. So can we when can we expect the delivery of the shipment of 140 metric tons to the company? So are we having any byproducts for development from the waste that we generate? So we have maintained just-in-time supplies from stockyard and warehouse. What are our plans to cope with the future wave, if any, if that strikes? So after, if there is any change in the name of the company, is there any proposition for that? So best wishes to the management and staff and on the entire workforce, and sir, under your leadership, I will hope our company will attain the bright future and reward the shareholders in coming years. And thank you, sir. And this video conference has helped us to get in contact with the company, and everybody stay safe. Thank you and namaskar.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bakshi. Mr. Santosh Saraf.
Mr. Saraf, your mic has been unmuted. You may start the video and speak, please.
Namaskar. Take minute. हाँ जी, माननीय अध्यक्ष जी, उपस्थित निजी सदस्यगण और मेरे शेयर होल्डर भाइयों बहनों, जो आज हम वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस के प्रेजेंट है, मैं संतोष कुमार साहब कलकत्ता अपने घर से बोल रहा हूँ। सर्वप्रथम आप सभी को मेरा नमस्कार। आशा करता हूँ आप हमारे जितने डायरेक्टर हैं और जितने भी हमारे एम्प्लॉई हैं और जितने भी स्टेक होल्डर और जो आज वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस के प्रेजेंट है उनकी और उनकी फैमिली इस कोविड के पीरियड में सुरक्षित और स्वस्थ होगी। सर, एक सर मैं अपनी संवेदना प्रकट करना चाहूँगा उन भाइयों के लिए जो इस कोविड की सिचुएशन में क्या तो हमें छोड़ के चले गए या इस कष्ट भरी में उनके कोई प्रेमी या जानकार छोड़ के चले गए, उनके लिए अपनी संवेदना प्रकट करना चाहूँगा। सर, एक सर भगवान से प्रार्थना कर रहा हूँ कि इस कठिन समय में हिम्मत दे। सर, एक तो मैं आपके कंपनी सेक्रेटरी को बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। मुझे मालूम नहीं था वो टाटा मेटल से कब उनको आप लेके आ गए, लेकिन जब पता लगा तो मुझे बहुत अच्छे सेक्रेटरी सर, तो बहुत माय डियर आदमी है, तो मैं चाहूँगा उनकी लंबी उम्र हो, इसी तरह टाटा में आगे बढ़ते रहे सर और एक जगह उन्नति करें। सर, एक सर मैं चाहूँगा उस हमारे कर्मचारियों को धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा जिनकी मेहनत के कारण हमें कई रिकॉग्निशन और अवार्ड्स मिले। सर, तो हमें दिखाता है कि हमारे कर्मचारी कितने सिंसियर हैं, इसके कारण मुझे अवार्ड मिले। सर, एक सर मैं मैनेजमेंट को धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा कि इस कोविड के टाइम में बहुत रिजनेबल डिविडेंड उन्होंने 5 रुपया करके दिया है, इसके लिए मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। सर, एक सर मैं जानना चाहूँगा अभी जो लोग बोलते हैं वेब 3 आ रही है, आपको करेला और महाराष्ट्र में इन कर चुकी है, तो उसके लिए हमारे क्या कदम आप उठा रहे हैं जिससे उसका इम्पेक्ट हमारी इनकम और ऑपरेशन में कम हो, और कॉस्ट कटिंग के क्या बारे में क्या कदम उठाए बताए। सर, क्या आपने बताया है कि इस साल आपने करीबन 42 करोड़ का कैपेक्स प्लान खर्चा किया है और आपके पास 1,227 करोड़ रुपया कैश व कैश इक्विपमेंट आपके पास में, तो सर फ्यूचर में इस पैसे को किस तरह आप कैपेक्स प्लान में खर्चा करना चाहेंगे, एक्विजिशन में या एक्सपेंशन में, इसके बारे में कोई विस्तार से बताने लायक हो अवश्य बताइएगा। सर, एक सर मैं आपसे जानना चाहूँगा सर, कि हमारे यहाँ फीमेल इम्प्लाई बहुत कम है सर, यहाँ करीबन आपको 2395 के अंदर 56 फीमेल इम्प्लाई है। तो मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ सर, फीमेल को मौका दीजिए, क्योंकि आप देखेंगे अभी ओलंपिक में उन्होंने हमारे लिए गोल्ड मेडल लाए हैं, जेंट्स में जो हॉकी वाले लाए बाकी कोई नहीं लेके आए। तो मैं चाहूँगा उनका अगर आप मौका देंगे, चाहे वो नौकरी के रूप में हो चाहे वो खिलाड़ियों को मौका दीजिए, जिससे वो अपने सेल्फ डिफेंड महसूस करें, उनका भविष्य सुरक्षित हो और अपने कर्म जो हैं अपने जो हैं वो आपको प्रकट कर सके सर। ऐसे मैं समझता हूँ वुमेन को अपॉइंटमेंट करना टाटा ग्रुप का कर्तव्य है और टाटा जरूर करेगी, लेकिन टाटा स्टील के अंदर में जो लोन में बहुत कम एम्प्लाई है सर। एक सर मैं जानना चाहूँगा अपने टोटल जो एम्प्लाई हैं कैजुअल लेके 7729 एम्प्लाई हैं इंक्लूडिंग परमानेंट एंड कैजुअल सर, तो इन एम्प्लाई का कितना परसेंट उनके परिवार का और उनके खुद एम्प्लाईयों का वैक्सीन लग चुका सर बताने का कष्ट करिए। और किसी ने अगर प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल में पैसा खर्चा करके ली है तो उनके उनके परिवार की दवाई वैक्सीन का खर्चा आपने उठाया है तो उसके बारे में बताने का कष्ट करिएगा सर। एक सर ये रेन वाटर हार्वेस्ट के बारे में आप क्या कदम उठाए हैं जिससे हम उस वाटर को जमीन में पहुँचा सकें और उसको अपने रिसाइकिल करके रीयूज कर सकें, जिससे फ्रेश वाटर की अपने। एक सर मैं ये बताने का कष्ट करिएगा कि हमारे ESG कमेटी का गठन किया गया या नहीं किया है, इन्वायरमेंट सोशल एंड गवर्नेंस कमेटी का गठन किया गया और इसको इसका कोई रिपोर्ट है उसके बारे में बताए, उन्होंने क्या रिपोर्ट हमारे कंपनी के लिए दी है ये बताने का कष्ट करिएगा सर। एक सर रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी के बारे में चाहूँगा आप क्या कदम उठा रहे हैं कि अपने जो फैक्ट्रियाँ होती है काफ़ी लंबी एरिया में रहती है तो उनके रूप हैं या अपने जो जगह है वहाँ के अपने सोलर पैनल या अन्य कोई चीज़ लगा के उसकी व्यवस्था कर सकें तो शायद अच्छा होगा, अपने फायदे का होगा सर। एक सर मैं जानना चाहूँगा, एक मिनट सर, एक सर मेरे को ये बताइए कि अपने कितने परसेंट कोई एम्प्लाई अगर वर्क फ्रॉम होम कर रहे हैं तो उनके लिए आपने क्या इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोवाइड किया जिससे वो आपस में अच्छे से कोऑर्डिनेट करके हमारी कंपनी का काम अच्छा से कर सके। एक सर मैं आपका पूरा सपोर्ट करता हूँ कि आपने जो मर्जर का डिसीजन लिया है मेरा पूरा सपोर्ट है। टाटा मेटली और टाटा स्पोन टाटा मेटली पहले भी मर्जर की बात उठी थी किसी, लेकिन बाधा देने से नहीं हुआ। अब मैं समझता हूँ अभी प्रॉब्लम है कि अब NCLT के थ्रू मर्जर होगा तो इससे उनके शेयर होल्डर को ऑब्जेक्शन देने का भी प्रश्न नहीं होता है, तो मैं चाहूँगा जल्दी से जल्दी मर्ज हो। और सर आपने नवंबर में कहा कि इसका डिसीजन हुआ है तो ये NCLT कब तक टाइम लेती है सर, इसका टाइम पीरियड कितने दिन में कंप्लीट होगा बताने का कष्ट करिएगा सर। एक सर मुझे एक चीज और बताने का कष्ट करिएगा लास्ट में कि अपने जो टोटल एम्प्लॉई हैं 2395 और कैजुअल को बात दी 2395 टोटल एम्प्लॉई है, इनके जोन वाइज और एज वाइज और जनरेटर वाइज, क्योंकि हर जोन से अपने आते हैं बंगाल बिहार से, तो उनका अगर फिगर आपके पास में अवेलेबल हो तो हमें पता लगेगा कि हमारी कंपनी में सब क्रांति कैसे एम्प्लॉई हैं, इसके लिए अपने डायबिटीज वाइज का पता लगेगा सर। और ज़्यादा समय मैं नहीं लूँगा, आप जितने हमारे डायरेक्टर प्रेजेंट हैं और जितने भी हमारे एम्प्लॉय प्रेजेंट हैं शेयर होल्डर प्रेजेंट हैं और हमारी बहनें भी प्रेजेंट, एक बहन का चेहरा दिखाई दे रहा है मेरे को यहाँ पर, तो मैं उनसे भी भगवान से प्रार्थना करता हूँ लंबी उम्र हो और इसी तरह कंपनी आगे बढ़े। और सर एक ये वर्चुअल मीटिंग में समझता हूँ बहुत अच्छी है सर, इसको कंटिन्यूस रखिए, क्योंकि अभी बोपन्ना जी और दिनेश कोटा जी बॉम्बे से अटेंड कर सके, अदरवाइज कलकत्ते की मीटिंग में बोपन्ना कभी नहीं अटेंड कर सके, उनको आना पड़ता है नहीं तो अपने घर से अटेंड करते हैं। ये फायदे है सर, रिस्क भी कम है और जो डायरेक्टर जहाँ रहते हैं वहाँ से अटेंड कर सकते हैं सर, तो मैं चाहूँगा इसको कंटिन्यू रखिए और ज़्यादा समय नहीं लेते आप लोग के लिए बहुत प्रार्थना करते वहाँ 2021 का जो फाइनेंशियल ईयर है हमारे जितने भी इम्प्लॉई हैं जितने भी डायरेक्टर हैं जितने भी स्टेक होल्डर जो हमारी कंपनी ग्रोथ में शामिल है उनकी उनकी फैमिली के सुख हो और हैप्पीनेस वेल्थ और सेफनेस के साथ उनको रखें। जय हिंद जय भारत, नमस्कार एक बार फिर मेरे से।
थैंक यू मिस्टर सरा। आई विल नाउ कॉल अपॉन मिस्टर बीके डिंडा, प्रेसिडेंट टाटा कामगार यूनियन गमारिया, टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स।
मिस्टर डिंडा, योर माइक हैज बीन अनम्यूटेड, यू मे स्टार्ट द वीडियो एंड स्पीक प्लीज।
respected chairman of board of TSLP, board of directors, managing director of TSLP, all senior leader of TSLP, and all shareholder attending the AGM. टाटा कामगार यूनियन से हमारी कंपनी के एजीएम का हिस्सा बनने का अवसर पाकर मैं काफी गौरवान्वित और सम्मानित महसूस कर रहा हूं। सबसे पहले हमारे चेयरमैन और टीएसएलपी बोर्ड को मेरी हार्दिक बधाई कि इन्होंने इस अधिग्रहित कंपनी को रूपांतरित करके इसे ग्रोथ एंड प्रॉफिट के पथ पर इस तरह अग्रसर किया जहां से आप एक स्थायी राइट फ्यूचर का भरोसा दिया जा सके। मैं टीएसएलपी एमडी को बधाई और धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूं। इस कंपनी को चलाते हुए उन्होंने सभी स्टेक होल्डरों की के अधिक उम्मीदों को कहीं अधिक खड़ा उतर गए। किसी भी अन्य कंपनी के अधिग्रहण के कंपैरिजन में टीएसएलपी अपने अधिग्रहण के पहले 2 वर्षों में ही प्रोडक्शन, प्रोडक्टिविटी, क्वालिटी, सेल्स, प्रॉफिट की उपलब्धियों से मील का पत्थर स्थापित करने वाली एक अनुकरणीय कंपनी बन चुकी है जो एक उज्जवल भविष्य का संकेत भी देता है। कुछ खास कंपनी के बारे में हम लोग जो काम किए उसके बारे में बताना चाहता हूँ। टीएसएलपी सेफ्टी एनवायरमेंट एंड एमिनिटीज पर ज्यादा से ज्यादा ध्यान देती है। खास करके हम गमारिया यूनिट का बात कर रहे हैं क्योंकि मैं प्रेसिडेंट गमारिया यूनिट की हूँ। कर्मचारी को फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी इन सेफ्टी को फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी दिया गया है। कर्मचारी के जीवन को मूल्यवान बनाया गया है। कर्मस्थल की सुरक्षा बढ़ाने, व्यावहारिक सुरक्षा, एपेक्स सुरक्षा समिति, कई तरह का कमेटी बना है जिसमें जितने भी कमेटी है उसमें यूनियन एंड मैनेजमेंट के ज्वाइंट भागीदारी है, पार्टिसिपेशन है। क्या एपेक्स सेफ्टी कमेटी हो या डिफरेंट सेफ्टी कमेटी हो, इवन मैनेजमेंट और यूनियन ने लाइन वर्क में भी ज्वाइंटली करती है ताकि किसी भी प्रिवेंटिव मेजर लिया जा सके ताकि किसी तरह का भी कोई तरह का हैपनिंग ना हो पाए। इन्वायरमेंट में हम लोग काफी जागरूक हैं और सभी एम्प्लॉई को इसका बारे में काफी जागरूक किया गया है। ओनरशिप का एक भावना पैदा किया गया है कि कंपनी हमारा, हम लोगों की कंपनी है और इस तरह से हम लोग पर्यावरण पर भी हम लोग ध्यान दिए हैं कि ट्री प्लांटेशन एंड कंपनी को किस तरह से ग्रीनरी किया जाए, ग्रीन अर्थ कैसे किया जाए, इस तरह भी हम लोग उस पर हम लोग ध्यान रखे हैं। प्रबंधन भी इस पर काफी एक साथ ज्वाइंटली मिलकर हम लोग इसको काम करते हैं। जीरो हार्म ये हम लोग का एक स्लोगन है और इसी तौर पर हम लोग चल रहे हैं कि हार्म किसी भी एक एम्प्लॉय का भी किसी तरह का काम ना हो। हम लोग दो वर्ष हुआ है अल्प समय में मैनेजमेंट और एचआर टीम ने काफी काम किया है और सभी कर्मचारी के हितों में काम किया है जिसको अप्रिशिएट मैं करना चाहता हूँ। यूनियन के प्रेसिडेंट के नाते यूनिक पॉलिसीज लाया गया है जिसका बेनिफिट वर्कर को उसका सर्विस को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए आया है क्योंकि वर्कर सबसे बड़ा एसेट होता है किसी भी कंपनी के लिए और इस कंपनी मानती है कि वर्कर का बेनिफिट, वर्कर के एमिनिटीज, वर्कर का वेलफेयर पर मैक्सिमम ध्यान दिया जा रहा है। मैं कोविड महामारी के पीरियड का भी बात करना चाहूँगा कि उस पीरियड में कर्मचारी को परिवार को किस तरह का सोशल सिक्योरिटी के तहत कई तरह का योजना बनाया गया है सामाजिक सुरक्षा के लिए और इसका एग्जाम्पल है कि किसी भी एम्प्लॉय को किसी भी तरह का कोई तरह का प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुआ और इसको प्रॉपर जितना भी हम लोग सुरक्षा योजना बनाए सोशल सिक्योरिटीज का और उसका लिए हम लोग इम्प्लीमेंटेशन उसका एक उदाहरण। इसके अलावा कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेबर को हम लोग अलग नहीं समझते हैं, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेबर भी हमारे पार्टनर हैं। हम लोग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेबर पर भी हम लोग ध्यान देते हैं, जिस तरह का परमानेंट एम्प्लॉय उस तरह के कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एम्प्लॉय का भी इस महामारी के दौरान सभी तरह का फैसिलिटीज, किसी भी तरह का उसको दिक्कत नहीं हुआ, चाहे फिनेंशियल हो चाहे उसका रोजगार से रिलेटेड हो, कभी कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, उस पर भी ध्यान दिया गया। यहाँ के एम्प्लॉय का या एम्प्लॉय के एकेडमिक स्कॉलरशिप या एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज पर भी प्रोत्साहन करने के लिए स्कॉलरशिप प्रोग्राम किया गया, स्कॉलरशिप दिया जाता है, इस साल से स्टार्ट हुआ। और इसमें कुछ और सोच डाइवर्सिफिकेशन के लिए भी हम लोग कुछ प्रबंधन के साथ मिलकर हम लोग कुछ सोच रहे हैं किस तरह से डाइवर्सिफिकेशन पर हम लोग जोड़ दें, इस पर भी प्रबंधन काफी एक्टिव है। इसी क्रम में प्रबंधन के कर्मचारी को वार्डों को ट्रेड अपेंडिस के तहत एम्प्लॉयमेंट मिले या ट्रेड अपेंडिस का सुविधा मिले, उसके लिए भी हम लोग ट्रेनिंग का प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट हो चुका है। कोविड पीरियड में कंपनी, सबसे बड़ी बात है कंपनी ने प्रायोरिटी दिया कर्मचारी के हित के लिए। कर्मचारी ये नहीं देखा, मैनेजमेंट ये नहीं देखा कि व्यवसाय को महत्व नहीं देखे, सबसे पहले एम्प्लॉय को एंड स्टेक होल्डर को सबसे महत्व ज्यादा दिया, जिससे प्रबंधन के प्रति लोग का आगाध विश्वास और माहौल पैदा हो। टाटा वैल्यू सिस्टम एक एग्जाम्पल है। और कोविड पीरियड में जो गवर्नमेंट का जो प्रोटोकॉल है, सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग है, सैनिटाइजेशन है, पीओडी प्रबंधन है, मास्क का उपयोग करने, प्लांट को कम वर्कफोर्स के साथ में काम कैसे किया जा सकता था, पॉट सिस्टम मैनेज करना, वर्क फ्रॉम होम की सुविधा, कोविड पॉजिटिव अगर हुए तो उसको स्पेशल चाहे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट या परमानेंट एम्प्लॉय का वो भी प्रावधान रखा गया, CWF को भुगतान सुनिश्चित करना आदि व्यवस्था भी सुनिश्चित की गई। 8,000 से अधिक कोविड परीक्षण हुआ परिवार के सदस्यों तथा 5,000 से अधिक लोगों को टीकाकरण कराया गया। विभिन्न स्तरों पर कोविड पॉजिटिव कर्मचारी एवं परिवारों को सुविधा प्रदान किया गया। इस महामारी के दौरान, इस संकट के घड़ी में टाटा कामगार यूनियन कंधे से कंधा मिलाकर खड़ा रहा। एक और इम्पोर्टेंट टाटा स्टील का टाटा फिलोसफी में है, टाटा फिलोसफी के तहत हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं। कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी जो कि बहुत पुराना चले आ रहा है, लेकिन यहाँ पर इस तरह का जो इस महामारी में देखा गया एकदम अलग तरीका का सामाजिक दायित्व को अपनाया गया। इसमें शेयर होल्डर को भी इस चीज को हम लोग बता रहे हैं कि उनको भी चिंता थी कि इस पीरियड में किस तरह का महामारी में कंपनी ने CSR का एक्टिविटी कर रही है। इस पीरियड में जितना भी प्रवासी बाहर से मजदूर आए हुए हैं, उन लोग का रहना, उन लोगों को खाना या उस तरह का उन लोगों को भोजन का आदि प्रावधान करना, राशन का प्रावधान करना, इवन रोजगार का भी प्रावधान करना, ये भी हम लोग किए। दूसरा चीज था कि जितना भी इस अगल बगल जितना भी आपका गांव देहात विलेजेस है या गरीब तबके के काफी दूर तक लोग भी जो रिक्वेस्ट करते हैं, उस जगह में भी सामान भोजन राशन वगैरह बांटा गया। मेडिकल का फैसिलिटी भी काफी हद तक दिया गया ताकि उस गांव में अगल बगल कंपनी के अगल बगल गांव के लोग को बीच में अपना एक कंपनी के प्रति उनका रुझान हो, कंपनी के प्रति कंपनी को लगे कि कंपनी हमारी है। क्योंकि ये भी हम लोग का एक ड्यूटी बनता है कि आसपास के गांव या विलेज या लोगों को, समाज को लेके हम लोग कैसे चले, और उस पर भी हम लोग खड़े उतरे हैं, उस पर भी हम लोग काफी काम किए। हम लोग जितना भी ज्वाइंट कमेटी है, ज्वाइंट कमेटी जितना भी कंपनी का कमेटी है उसमें ज्वाइंट कमेटी है, हम लोग विश्वास करते हैं वर्किंग टुगेदर कॉन्सेप्ट पर। वर्किंग टुगेदर कॉन्सेप्ट एक ऐसा कॉन्सेप्ट है जिसको हम लोग बोल सकते हैं कि ज्वाइंट कंसल्टेशन बोल सकते हैं या क्लोजर एसोसिएशन बोल सकते हैं या हम लोग बोल सकते हैं कि पार्टनरशिप। आज के दिन में हम लोग यूनियन एंड मैनेजमेंट बोल के अलग नहीं, हम लोग एक पार्टनर का तहत जॉइंटली काम कर रहे हैं ताकि कंपनी आगे बढ़े, कंपनी का ग्रोथ हो, कंपनी का ग्रोथ होगा तो वर्कर का भी ग्रोथ होगा। ये वर्किंग टुगेदर कॉन्सेप्ट हम लोग टाटा स्टील या टाटा स्टील से भी हम लोग इसको अपनाए हैं, जो टाटा स्टील में बेस्ट 100 साल से चले आ रहा है। और एक टाटा का फिलोसफी भी है कि वर्कर और मैनेजमेंट बोल के अलग अलग कोई तरह का बात ना हो, दोनों एक मिल के काम करें। जितने भी कमेटी है, हर कमेटी में ज्वाइंट कमेटी इक्वल नंबर है, चाहे वो कैंटीन कमेटी हो या जितना भी कमेटी हो, उस कमेटी में हम लोग ज्वाइंटली हम लोग उसको एक करके चल रहे हैं। छोड़ दीजिए, ज्वाइंट कमेटी है उसमें कैंटीन कमेटी है या सेफ्टी एपेक्स कमेटी है, जितना भी कमेटी जितने भी कमेटी है उस कमेटी में हम लोग ज्वाइंट पार्टिसिपेशन है वर्कर एंड मैनेजमेंट एंड यूनियन का, और उसके तहत हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं, चाहे क्वालिटी में हो, चाहे सेफ्टी में हो, चाहे प्रोडक्टिविटी हो या प्रॉफिट, सभी चीज में हम लोग इक्वल हम लोग मेहनत करते हैं या हम लोग भागीदारी करते हैं। एक टाटा कामगार यूनियन और मैनेजमेंट का बोनस समझौता हुआ, जिस बोनस समझौता में भी हम लोग इस चीज को, इस पैरामीटर को हम लोग रखे हैं। किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का ग्रोथ में, किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ग्रोथ के लिए इंडस्ट्रियल हार्मोनी सबसे बड़ा जरूरी होता है, और टाटा टीएसएलपी मैनेजमेंट टाटा कामगार यूनियन मिल के काम करती है, और हम लोग ये सोच के काम करते हैं कि हम लोग कंपनी को आगे बढ़ाए, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को आगे बढ़ाए, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अगर आगे बढ़ेगा तो ये हमारा एम्प्लॉय को उसका फायदा मिलेगा और उसका प्रॉपर शेयर हम एम्प्लॉय को भी हम लोग को मजबूती से इसको हम लोग मिलेगा। यही हमारा एक छोटा सा विचार था जो हम आप लोगों के सामने समक्ष रखा। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू मिस्टर डिंडा। आई विल नाउ कॉल अपॉन मिस्टर संजय महंता, प्रेसिडेंट टाटा स्टील लॉन्ग प्रोडक्ट्स वर्कर्स यूनियन जोड़ा, टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स।
मिस्टर महंता, योर माइक हैज बीन अनम्यूटेड, यू मे स्टार्ट द वीडियो एंड स्पीक प्लीज।
गुड आफ्टरनून चेयरमैन सर। जयदि टाटा कहिथिले उच्च मन ओ कठिन परिश्रम बिना किछि भी प्राप्त होवो नै। आज सही उच्च मन ओ कठिन परिश्रम रे टाटा ग्रुप पृथ्वी रे एको उच्च स्थान रे रही अछि। रेस्पेक्टेड चेयरमैन ऑफ बोर्ड ऑफ टीएसएलपी, बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स, मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर ऑफ टीएसएलपी, ऑल सीनियर लीडर ऑफ टीएसएलपी एंड ऑल शेयरहोल्डर्स अटेंडिंग द एजीएम, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ टीएसएलपी वर्कर्स यूनियंस आई फील प्रिविलेज गेटिंग अपॉर्चुनिटी टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द एजीएम ऑफ आवर कंपनी। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू कंग्रेचुलेट आवर चेयरमैन एंड बोर्ड सेटिंग एंड शॉपिंग टीएसएलपी सक्सेसफुली एंड टेकिंग दिस फॉरवर्ड टू become a sustainable company. I would congratulate and extend my sincere thanks to managing director of TSLP for driving this company to meet more than expectation of all stakeholders. In 2 years, we have experienced number of achievements and milestone in production, sales, profit, and creating a caring environment. To ensure safe workplace, management and union joining hand with hand and driving safety culture in company to ensure zero harm. Number of best practices and effective safety programs and initiatives are taking place in the company. We would like to appreciate our management and HR team for bringing a unique employee related policies, benefits and services. We are happy to say that employees are very happy with the proactive implementation of social security schemes by the company to ensure financial security of family members of the aged employee during the pandemic. The employees' policies and experience has seen a transformational change in last 1 year of TSLP. It gives me immense pride that we are all of such a caring company. I am proud to say that senior leadership team of the company has taken the challenges to fight against the COVID pandemic and ensure the business to continue with utmost employee care, and during the period of union stood strongly with team. Leadership direction and regular review on COVID guidelines, testing, facilitating special leave on COVID positive, medical care, extending all support on critical cases and hospitalization, and ensuring 100% vaccination to its all employees, family members and contact workforce is highly appreciable. Though we lost some of our colleagues, we have contained the spread. We are also thankful to the company for taking care of the family through family benefit scheme, which reflects the uniqueness of Tata towards employees and their family. We are happy to express that during COVID-19, relief distributed to our community through our CSR response program and restored livelihoods of members of migrants. Organized Tata camps during the year, we all participated in the Tata Group's TBW program and bagged different awards. The best part of our union
जी आप है उधर Ashish, can you check if he's able to connect back?
इसको थोड़ी मालूम है जो ठीक कर रहे
मिस्टर महांता सीम्स टू बी फेसिंग नेटवर्क इश्यूज
ओके देन वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द मीटिंग आई विल रिस्पोंड टू द क्वेश्चंस फेस्ड बाय द शेयर होल्डर्स थैंक यू ऑल फॉर द क्वेश्चंस कमेंट्स सजेशंस एंड एप्रिसिएशन for the work that has been done. Ms. Arun, you talked about the vaccination. Basically, more than 90% of our employees and contract workers have received the first dose. More than 30% of our employees have received the second dose, and about 6% of the contract workers. But we are running a very big drive across all our locations, not just in Tata Steel Long Products, but the Tata Steel Group, to make sure that the vaccination is done. And people are safe. So that is something that we're doing. You're asked about legacy assets. There are no legacy assets for us to write off. For us to become future ready, Ashish has presented and the report talks about it, but largely we want to grow over a period of time to be a significant size. We want to grow to about 10 million tons over a period of time because there is an opportunity to grow in long products. And of course, we will pace it well. We will make sure that the balance sheet is strong. And I think there was another question that we will not overpay for any of the assets. I think we will keep all those suggestions in mind. We will look for profitable and sustainable growth. We look for driving operating efficiencies, focus on safety, sustainability, and CSR, and continue to embrace digital and technology and create a future-ready culture. Yes, long products will grow with urbanization. Will grow with infrastructure, and of course, given our product mix, we are also into specialty long, so we will grow along with auto and other such specialized applications. On mitigating ESG risks, we have also covered it in the integrated report. I think page 22 to 31 covers it. Mr. Kapoor, how is the demand shaping up? Well, I think you were also asking about what is structural, what is cyclical. I think there are two or three things which are happening globally in the steel industry, which is translating into higher prices than we've seen in the past. One is China is rethinking its own approach to exports of steel, because China is trying to reduce the steel capacity in China, reduce its carbon footprint in China. So they are not seeing any logic to import raw material and export finished products and leave a carbon footprint behind in China. So they're discouraging exports of steel, which is bringing some stability to the global trade in steel and which is helping international prices stay high. Second thing which is happening is post-pandemic, many governments have announced packages, infrastructure packages, whether it's the US, whether it's Europe, whether it's China, whether it's India. Many governments, or most governments who can afford to spend their way out of trouble, are spending money on building infrastructure, and that is good for the demand for steel. Third is climate-related costs in Europe are keeping the cost structures high, so there is less motivation to reduce prices because the cost base has gone up. And fourth is there are geopolitical issues with China and Australia, which is leading high cost input for China, particularly for coal, and which is also making sure that the steel prices will stay high because input costs are high for the Chinese steel companies. So while I will not comment whether today's steel price will stay for long, but certainly I can tell you that we expect this decade the steel prices to be better than it was in the last decade. If you remember, 2000 to 2010 was driven more by China growth. 2010 to 2020 was driven more by China exports. And I think we are going back to a more stable environment for the future. Merger with ISWP Metallics, I think the reasons, while we had applied to SEBI saying that these are to be done together or parallelly, but I think SEBI's question to us was more looking at it as a transaction. We are taking it up with them. Their concern was, if you merge ISWP, will the public share come below the level stipulated by SEBI? So we are dealing with that. The PLI scheme, yes, has benefits for specialty steel, some of the products that we're thinking of for expansion. There are, of course, conditions for PLI scheme. I think the maximum benefit you can get is 200 crores per group. And also, I think you have to commit a certain investment and a commit year on your growth and volume. So we are working out all that. Yes, royalty charges have also gone up because of the fact that the iron ore prices have gone up, and royalties typically linked to the iron ore. So basically for us, for the Jodha plant, pretty much all the iron ore comes from Tata Steel, whereas for the Gamharia plant, most of the iron ore comes from Tata Steel Long Products' own mine. In terms of, I take your suggestion that the virtual medium should become more permanent. I also take your suggestion that there should be more frequent communication with the investors, which I'll leave to Ashish and Shankar to work off. Mr. Jain, thank you for your comments and suggestions. Your comment on growth, yes, as I mentioned, we have a growth ambition, but as we said, we will also be prudent with that growth currently. And when we talk about growth, I think when we talk in the Tata Steel context of long products growth, obviously, while Tata Steel Long Products is the vehicle, if there are opportunities which are bigger, we will think about what would be the right way to structure it. But primarily, we will make sure that Tata Steel Long Products, whatever growth it pursues, is sustainable and supported by Tata Steel. Basically, if you look at our current footprint, we do believe that in the Gamharia plant, the steel making can be taken to 1 million tons. It's the investment that we need is to make in the rolling mill, because the rolling capacity is about 700,000 tons. So we have developed plan to invest in a rolling mill. We also have an opportunity, as you or one of the other shareholders mentioned, there are inorganic growth of, organic growth opportunities. There is land available in Jodha, while in Gamharia there is no space available within where we are. But in Jamshedpur, there are other locations. For instance, even if ISWP comes in the fold, there is an opportunity there as well. So I think your company is well positioned. It can pursue organic or inorganic growth opportunities. We also have a plan to grow through the scrap-based route, as was mentioned, which is also a capital light way to grow, because there we will have partners investing in facilities, but we will control the quality and we will obviously own the not only the whole value chain in some sense of the term, but own the quality and the relationship with the customer. I think the with Metallics and ISWP, the advantages of the merger are linked to more efficiencies in terms of overlapping costs, better sharing of good practices and knowledge, because both Tata Metallics and Tata Steel Long Products run blast furnaces of similar sizes or smaller sizes. Both are, in some sense, connected to the infrastructure and construction space in a big way. So we do see a lot of advantages at multiple points in the value chain, apart from driving efficiencies, and that's why we were pursuing the merger. So this also partly addresses Mr. Maheshwari's question on the rationale for the merger. What are the replacement costs for the assets? Mr. Maheshwari asked that. I think it's about, if I were to say it, it's about 7,000 to 8,000 crores for the Gamari assets, and maybe about 700 to 800 crores for the assets. How do we plan to balance the expansion and debt profile? I think both at the Tata Steel level and at a subsidiary level, our original goal was to bring the debt to EBITDA to below 2.5. I think all companies are comfortably below that. So we have said that in the long term, through cycle, we will look at keeping it around 2. So if we are less than 2, that gives you a sense of what is the headroom that is available. In terms of CapEx spends over the next few years, basically the plan is, I think the plan which is being developed so far is about, this is more from just existing, I'm not talking of inorganic, I'm talking of existing organic growth plans of downstream to supplement the Gamaria unit. I think it's about 1,800 crores, out of which 1,000 crores is for growth and 800 crores is for sustenance over the next 5 years. Mr. Gupta, what is the next target? You'll hear of it when we kind of pursue it, but we've said in public that we are interested in growth in long products as Tata Steel Group and as Tata Steel Long Products, because in that product, Tata Steel is comfortable that it has. Note your question on the registered office. You know, Metallics is merging with Tata Steel Long Products, whose registered office is in Godha. We have other Tata companies who are registered in Calcutta, so we will, I'm sure, have more opportunities to meet for other subsidiaries as well. You asked about a plant visit. Again, I'll leave it to Ashish and Shankar to see if it's possible. But obviously, at this point in time, we have a lot of restrictions, not only on travel, but also on plant visits. Pecha, well, thank you for your words, and thank you for asking us to chase 10,000 crores in 3 years. Let's see where we get there. You had also asked about customer service teams. We have 6 customer service teams now, and these are customer service teams is a concept where you have a cross-functional team of operating people, marketing and sales people, planning people, supply chain people, all working together to build a relationship with the customer and solve the customer's problems, technology people. So it's a concept that we deploy extensively in the Tata Steel Group and Tata Steel Long Products and continue to deploy it. The ACE platform is more to capture the feedback. And PSIL Energy is a subsidiary which was created at one point in time to deal with the Radhe Kapoor coal block, which has gone back. So the board of PSIL has already taken a decision. Recognize and appreciate employees for excellent work. We have multiple initiatives. We have something called Steelers, which is also about celebrating and recognizing good work done by the employees. You asked how are we prepared for Black Swan events. I must tell you that Tata Steel Group and Tata Steel Long Products, all companies have a risk management process, which is reasonably mature. So we always look out at bottom-up risk, top-down risk, and between multiple companies in the group also we share the risk so that we have a robust approach to dealing with risk. Mr. Bakshi, again, the disruptions, yes, last year Q1 we were at one point in time less than 50% of the capacity, but I think Tata Steel Long Products was the first company in the Tata Steel Group to reach 100% capacity. I think by the end of June they had reached that level. We have an order book of from commercial vehicles and automobile, not much of interaction, not much of order book from railways. Debt reduction, yes, you've seen the debt reduction. We will, like I said, we'll be prudent. We have brought down debt very significantly. We will continue that while at the same time look out for growth opportunities. On tire cord, yes, that's a shipment which is being made to Thailand, and we will wait for the feedback. It is a very good development. Not many companies in the world can make tire cord, but I think Tata Steel Long Products has demonstrated that they can do. That's all credit to the team. In terms of female employees, yes, Mr. Santosh Saraf, point taken. This is an agenda that we have again at Tata Steel Group level, Tata Steel Long Products. We need to improve the number, not just the overall number of female employees, but also how can we have more female employees on the shop floor. There are a number of initiatives being taken. Rainwater harvesting is also being done in many of our locations. And work from home was a flexibility that we offered, not only because of the situation, but also because now we have found that employees are not lacking in productivity, because technology allows us to operate productively from wherever they are. We are basically moving towards the culture of holding employees accountable for the outcomes, trusting them that it doesn't matter where they sit, but if they focus on the outcomes, they will be able to deliver, while at the same time, the office is always available for people to come and interact. So I think I've covered much all the questions that were raised. I thank you all once again for joining us, for the questions that you asked. I will now authorize Mr. Shankar Bhattacharya, the company secretary and compliance officer, to conduct the voting procedure and conclude the meeting. The remote e-voting facility will remain open for the next 15 minutes to enable shareholders to cast their votes. The results will be announced within 48 hours from the conclusion of this meeting. The same will be intimated to the BSE Limited and National Stock Exchange of India Limited, and also uploaded on the website of the company and of NSDL. I thank the shareholders for attending the meeting and for their continued support. I also thank the directors for joining the meeting remotely. And with your consent, the board members and I would like to leave the meeting, and I request all shareholders to stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you very much.
The e-voting was kept open for 15 minutes as had been announced by the chairman. We now close the e-voting process. I confirm that the requisite quorum was present throughout the meeting. The results of the annual general meeting will be announced on or before August 7, 2021. With this, I declare the meeting as closed. Thank you.